Welcome to Reaching Out to the Unfamous. Now, today's episode, I'm going to talk about my good friend, Erin Lee, also known by her DeviantArt username, Erin Lee. And as you might imagine, she has a very amazing series of comic books, which you will find on places like Patreon and Tapastic, or simply known as tapas.com, and I think Comic Fury maybe, I don't know, but she also runs, she doesn't run groups, but she's a member of two groups on DeviantArt, and she's also a very talented artist, not just in comics, but in general. She's a very talented artist, and did I say artist? I mean artist, yeah. Anyway, her gallery consists of works that she composed on her own, in her own time, completely original works that would otherwise be considered very, very professionally drawn, very realistic, but at the same time has a special comic book slash manga feel to it, and also has a very ring to it, as it's completely unique in its own special way, and here's why. See, the thing is, her artwork is very, very, very impressive, as you might imagine. It's very, very impressive. Very, very, very impressive. It's astounding. It's exquisite. It's unique in its own way. It's original. It's genuine. It's absolutely
glorious!
It totally reeks of geniuses, complete geniuses, and I say that in the best and most complimentary way possible. Now, judging, she does have several comics, including Watch the Zodiac, Satan and the Middleman, and of course my personal favorite webcomic of hers, The Conductor, which centers around a teenage schoolgirl named Kazumi, is supposedly deemed criminally insane by her elders and a council at the school, and for whatever reason, she is supposedly, secretly, a universal protector, meaning that she's the protector of the cosmos, and that Kazumi herself holds the key to restoring balance in the universe to prevent an early apocalypse.
Absolutely.
Now, the reason why I say this, of course, is really simple. Her comic style in this particular series is quite unique. Unlike most of the things that I've ever seen, very much unlike most of the things I've seen, and I've seen a lot. I've seen literally millions and millions and millions of talented artists all over the world, on DeviantArt and YouTube and television and other sorts of media in general. And it's crazy. She's completely genius at what she does. She's unique. She's talented. She's got that it factor. It's everything that you're looking for in an artist like that, and then some, which in my mind says a lot. And what's also important is the fact that she's also a very talented sketcher as well. As far as I know, she's one of those people that does live streams, as far as I can see, but then again, what would I do, right? Here's just another one of her works, her Wake Up Doodle from the 1st of June, or perhaps maybe the 6th of January, depending on what time zone you're in. I mean, it could be January 6th, or it could be June 1st. But I'm going to go with the latter and say June 1st. But this is her doodle from that day, 2015, roughly 2.5 years ago. And judging based on what I see in this piece, it is totally remarkable in almost any sense, despite maybe a couple of flaws, which I'm pretty sure were intentional, to show that necessarily have to be perfect in any professional sense or every professional sense or whatever sense in order to make Astounding art. But aside from that, this is very, very well drawn. I really like this. And I also like this fan art that she did of Donatello from the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, which, by the way, I'm not sure who created this series, but I do know that it was 30 years ago when the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles were created. Did I say Turtles? Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Let that sink in your head for a minute. But the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles have been very, very immensely popular since practically 1986 or 7, so about 31 or 32 years, basically. And this one is remarkable and totally top-notch. And this was written this was a fan art that was drawn 3 years ago, ironically. And this was one of her earliest drawings, if I remember correctly. Or maybe it was somewhere in the middle of her art career, I'm not sure, but I will say wholeheartedly, given how professionally drawn this was, this is in fact one of her crowning achievements that, in my mind, put her on the main stage as far as artists are concerned. And I would also like to point out that this is also one of her best works as a whole, in general. I mean, everything else on this, you know, it's crazy. It's crazy what she does in her art. She makes it all personally stand out, not just in life, but from a professional perspective. And it's so astounding to me how talented she is. It's very astounding. And I know that I'm not usually one to kiss people's behinds or whatever, but in this case, let's just say that we'll make an exception. And let's also point out the fact that this is one of the most talented artists out there that I personally can think of. Right up there with other notable artists within the art community, such as Beck Keith, also known by her DeviantArt username Sparacon, which is also the name of her comic book website that she and her husband, Rick Portner, had been running since about 2008 or 9. But that site's been on hold for some reason because Beck Keith is working on a novelization of her comic book that she and Rick work on called A Lunatic's Tale, which I'll get to that in a future episode. But back to Erin Lee. She is the kind of artist that, in all seriousness, has a special style about her that's not only exquisite and not only extraordinary, but something that takes a lot of guts and glory to go about. And let me tell you, this isn't even the tip of the iceberg, because believe it or not, her earliest works, as far as I can tell, were from way back when, and we all know that despite not being as mature as her current works, they still retain that sense of originality to them that makes them completely unique in their own special way. And that tells me, at least in my mind, that she's got it, legitimately and figuratively. She's got it. Absolutely, she's got it. And there's no question about it, you know, just look at her DeviantArt page. ErinLee.deviantart.com. But don't forget to put the HTTPS and then the colon and then two slashes in there. I'm not sure if they're backslashes or what, but I know that they're slashes nonetheless. But she has been on DeviantArt since early 2013. I'm not going to say what day specifically, because I don't want to give any spoilers, but she's been on DeviantArt for around that period of time. And her style has become so incredible, and yet at the same time so surreal, abstract, that that, it kind of makes you wonder who inspired her to begin with. Perhaps the people that I know personally. Like her doodle of Sardonyx from Steven Universe. Not only does Sardonyx look absolutely smexy as far as her character design goes, but she pretty much looks like what a typical female symphonic dirigent should look like in a concert hall performing live from an audience, except Sardonyx is wearing panties, and that's not necessarily concert appropriate. I think a dress would be more suitable, but yeah, just a simple mini skirt or a skirt in general, you know, stuff like that. But, you know, stuff like that, right? I mean, even pants, no, they work on a man just as much as they do a woman, so this makes sense. But yeah, this is one of her best works, in my opinion, that doodle from the morning of January the 21st, about 51 weeks ago, to the best of my knowledge. So, that was about 364 days ago, by my count, or it could have been 365, since last year was a 366-day calendar. So, it just makes sense either way. So, but anyway, all these artworks that I'm featuring in this video are pretty much just fan art or original art that she herself created as it pertains to books like, you know, I would say Steven Universe, which is a Cartoon Network series created by Rebecca Sugar, I believe, and TMNT, who I still, as of now, don't really know or remember exactly photographic memory who created it, but there's this one picture material in particular that I think served as her first submission from March of 2013. Keep in mind that I submitted my first deviation about 13 months after I became a member of the site under my current DeviantArt username, because the original username that I had used, I logged into officially and signed up for 5 days before making the current one that I'm active on. And needless to say, it goes without saying that this undoubtedly is one of her best works, you know? Because it's a fan art of Kantan no Shikishiya, which is, from what I can tell, probably a Japanese anime or manga or whatever, you know, or a manga of some kind. Because that's how the Japanese prefer to call mangas mangas. So, yeah, it just makes sense. It makes perfect sense, doesn't it? I mean, you tell me. What's good? But anyway, that's pretty much going to do it for you, you know? And other than that, I think, personally, that you should check out her artwork, because it's absolutely ridiculous, and I mean that in the best way possible. Let me tell you how good it is. Not only is it good, it's a special kind of good. The kind of good that you can't get in many other places except on DeviantArt or Tumblr or YouTube or other sorts of places of that nature. And it goes without saying that Ari Rin Lee is very much an artist that I personally think needs more recognition and fame, because her DeviantArt page only has, to the best of my knowledge, about 10,000 views, a little over 10,000 views. So, I'm just going to tell you straight up, I encourage all of you people on YouTube and social media to check her work out and give her some constructive feedback or criticism about it. But be nice to her, please, because she has worked too hard for too long, and she deserves honest feedback, because that's what she needs. And besides that, I wish you all adieu, and I also wish you all a very happy rest of your holiday season. Episode 3 of Reaching Out to the Unfamous is coming soon, so be sure to check that out. Laters!
Hey, hey!